Good afternoon.
Okay.
Sorry, I was.
Good afternoon. Thank you for attending this webinar. So, audience, I will introduce you. Ibu Rini Mesa is a Shortlight Country Manager in Indonesia. After graduating from University of Wollongong with Bachelor in Business or Marketing, she worked in various education companies. She has been with Shortlight since 2015 and representing more than 20 universities in the USA. So don't waste your time. If you have anything question about universities in USA, please ask Ibu Rini. So Ibu Rini, the screen is yours. Please. Thank you. You're still mute.
Okay. Yes, I just get access. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you for the moderator. Thank you so much for ELT Undana, Nusa Cendana, that already invite me. And of course, this today I'm not by myself. I will have my colleague also, others from the university that will join soon. And then, yeah, of course, behalf of USNG, US News, a Global Education, Shortlight, and part of the university that I represent. Thank you so much for invite us. And then hopefully that what I will inform will give the benefits for all the audience of participants that attend this webinar today. Okay, I will share my screen. Okay, great. Let me start. Can you see my screen? Wait, a bit of stuck. Okay. Study in the USA with US News Global Education. Okay. Then, wait, why I cannot? Okay. I'll start with my slides now. Can everyone see my slide?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay.
Okay, so as an introduction, actually, today I will represent US News. Everyone wonder what is Shortlight, what is US News Global Education, and also I put on the screen US News World Report. Okay, so US News Global Education is actually founded in September 2016 by US News and World Report and Shortlight as a company that assists international students to study in US. So the US Global Education, we are the premier higher education sources in the United States, providing services for students, education counselor, higher education institution. US News Global Education work with US News and World Report to help international students and their family to getting the information and then sending or for the parents and students to arrive on campus. I will mix Indonesian and English if it's okay. All right, okay.
That's all be fine.
Okay, so what is US News and World Report? Okay, in US, untuk mengetahui bahwa bagaimana university itu, they are the best or not, they are good in what fields, they are good in the secara national ranking or not, US menggunakan yang namanya US News and World Report Ranking. But actually, US News and World Report Ranking bukan merankingkan hanya education, but if you see on slide, if you're looking for anything in US, for example, you must study in US, uni mana yang bagus? Secara nasional, secara regional, secara departemen, secara major, maka kita menggunakan US News and World Report Education. Untuk mengetahui health, pokoknya tentang kesehatan dan lain-lain di US, US News World Report juga ada bagiannya. Kemudian traveling, cars, news, and other information. Dan ini adalah statistik yang dipakai banyak travelers atau educator pada saat mereka mau visit atau mengetahui tentang US dari masing-masing portionnya. Jadi ini adalah Multiface Digital Media Company ya, yang gunanya untuk memberikan information kepada locals maupun international, jadi citizen maupun international peoples, not the only citizen. Okay, everyone's wonder, so how many rank? Apakah US using hanya US News on the, okay. Untuk ranking pendidikan itu di US kita menggunakan nama US News and World Report Ranking, tapi mungkin pada tahu bahwa di dunia ini ada beberapa ranking ya. Ada yang namanya KS World Ranking, ada THE World Ranking, ada AWRU World Ranking, ada Shanghai Jungtong World Ranking. Jadi untuk US News kenapa kita menggunakan nanti ada di slide berikutnya, because US adalah negara yang memiliki university terbanyak di dunia. Oke, okay. Untuk mendapatkan ranking baik itu secara nasional, secara departemen, secara region, secara major, ada 4 klasifikasi poin yang dipakai, yaitu background on this year ranking, contohnya 2022, itu sudah keluar rankingnya, sekarang masih 2021. Jadi ranking US News menggunakan mengeluarkan ranking itu di setiap bulan September setiap tahun untuk tahun berikutnya. Jadi sekarang sudah November sehingga ranking 2022 sudah keluar. Variabelnya adalah background ranking tahun 2021. Kemudian determination ranking juga ada beberapa faktor, ada ranking faktor. Dan 100% itu dari outcomes. Outcomes itu apa aja? Adalah mereka memberikan satu kayak form ya untuk diisi oleh faculty, oleh students dan lain-lain. Kemudian graduation and retention rates. Artinya berapa students yang register masuk ke campus dan berapa yang lulus, ya kan? Kemudian percentage-nya berapa? Itu juga dipakai. Faculty resources, kemampuan dari setiap fakulti, ada berapa banyak fakulti, yang ngajarnya seperti apa, artinya lecture-nya itu mereka punya pendidikan di level mana, apakah mereka PhD, profesor, lalu mereka juga punya jam terbang seperti apa. Expert opinion, biasanya kita minta, biasanya didapatkan dari beberapa pakar ya di bidang pendidikan. Financial resources, university tersebut, apakah mereka, dari mana mereka mendapatkan pembiayaan untuk run the university, ya, itu sekitar 10%. Student excellence, student lulus dengan rata-rata nilainya berapa, jadi S1, S2, dan S3. Kemudian alumni giving, artinya biasa di US itu, alumni biasa memberikan kembali dalam bentuk pendanaan kepada alma maternya. Jadi ini adalah 10 besar yang menjadi acuan suatu university diberikan ranking. Jadi mungkin tahu ya, karena biasanya kalau mau cari university apply, ini uninya bagus apa tidak ya, ranking berapa ya, seperti itu. Ada beberapa grup ranking, ada 4 klasifikasi grup ranking. Ada National University Ranking, ya secara nasional, dari sekitar hampir 4.000 university yang mengoffer bachelor degree. Kemudian ada National Liberal Arts College, ada Regional University, dan ada Regional College. Oke, okay, setelah kita ke US News sedikit, kemudian history yang saya info tadi tentang US News Global, apa yang kita berikan kepada international student? What we exclusive services that US News Global Education giving to the international students? One, we give the application assistance. So if you interest to study in US, regardless you are self-paying students or you are sponsored students, we help you in terms of you your application process. So we'll help you, for example, we tell you about what type of university that you're looking for, what major that you're looking for, maybe you're looking for ranking or you're looking at a university that in specific area, like maybe I wanna study in the, you know, college town. I wanna just study. I wanna study in the metropolitan area, such as we will help, and also we'll help them to fill up the applications until you know, all the documents. We will inform the students because every university, they have different admission requirement or documents that they will request the student to submit it. And then assigned counselor. As part of also US News Global Education, I'm also the counselor for every student, each of the students that would like to know about study in US. And then major field of study guidance that I mentioned before, of course, the scholarship. Okay. So US offer US university, we offer lots of scholarship actually for international students, but it's more competitive because, you know, lots of students for will apply for the scholarship. I believe now the seminar will talk about tips and tricks how for you to apply for the scholarship. And then, but also, of course, I know that Indonesian government also, you know, offering the scholarship. So in US, you either get a scholarship from your from the country that the students come from, or from the US government, and then also from the university itself. That a lot of university offer scholarship, a type of scholarship. You can be like, if you are an athlete, if you are good, probably you can get a partial scholarship or full scholarship. If you are good in something or you are the winner of Olympic, regardless like athletes or mathematics or others, you have a chance to get the partial or full scholarship. So that's about a scholarship. And then pre-arrival guidance, of course, visa interview. Then just a good news for everyone who would like to apply to US, you don't have to worry like other countries that's struggling for the visa. The success rate for the US students visa almost 100% from Indonesia. Especially if you get a sponsor, or you get a scholarship and you apply for visa, it's 100% will be approved. And then for the preparations, like webinar, we also, having a webinar from each of the university that students can attend. And then the last one for the pre-guidance, help with required forms. Anything, for example, oh, I don't know how to fill up the immigration form, you don't have to worry, we will help you. The third one, campus transition, because we will help students to pick up them at the airport, at the destination's city, yeah, university, and we will pick up them. And then it depends, students, for the bachelor degree students, more likely they will stay on campus. For master or PhD, more likely students will stay off campus. So we'll pick from the airport and then drop them at the appointed accommodation that they already arranged for that. Student and parent orientation, culture group outings, we also give it. And then when students start the schools, right, start the class, we have class of your academic levels. If you need more English in terms of English, you know, writing, we will help the students, because most of the international students, more likely they have a problem in writing. Okay. And also we give the a free tutorial. Everything is free, right, guys? Jadi ini gratis, yeah. It's not like you have to pay the additional fee. The tutorial, regardless you need more mengenai mathematics atau kamu minta untuk specific topics, we'll provide the free tutor for each of the students. It can be individual tutoring or it can be a group, okay? And the last one that is important and Mac US also, lots of students would like to study in US about the career. Can I stay in US after study? Can I work in US during my study or after study? The answer, yes. For F1 students, you can work in US during your study, 24 hours a week. And then for after study, you will stay depends of your major. For anyone, regardless their bachelor, master, and PhD, any major, they will eligible to stay and work in US up to 12 months after study. And for those taking a major in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, they can extend until another 24 months. The total will be 3 years to stay in US or work in US by using student visa. You don't have to change to a working visa because it kind of a bit of complicated, because if you're using the working visa, if you have to change to working visa, you have to find a sponsor. You have to pay for the sponsor and it takes longer. So this is what we offer to our students, the service that we offer for this one. And this align with, you know, why a lot of, you know, students would like to study in US. Anyone know how many university in US? How many institutions that have bachelor degree in US? Maybe anyone can guess me, just one. Maybe I give 1 minute. You can type. How many university in US? We have 50 states and one capital city, which is Washington, D.C., District of Columbia. Okay, we have almost 4,000 university. Wow, that's a lot. No other countries that have numbers of university. And then the reason why lots of international students would like to come and study in U.S. because academic excellence. If you see by KSO ranking, they use for world ranking, 48 out of 100 top university in the world is in U.S. You can name it Harvard and others. And we have a lot of university, we can say that we have a good academic excellence. And the next one, U.S. is well known for research and development. So we can claim that we are world-class research facilities. So because of that, there's a lot of university that, you know, they have, mereka mendapatkan pendanaan yang sangat fantastis. Ada yang mendapatkan sampai 500 juta US dollar untuk per tahun ya, bukan dalam mungkin 5 tahun, no, per tahun untuk di bagian research fundingnya. Yang berikutnya, kenapa orang suka ke US? Ya, karena ada scholarship. Pastinya ada pendanaan. Yang tadi sudah saya mention, kemudian berikutnya lagi, connection in leading industry. Kenapa kok bisa di leading industry? Karena tadi di poin kedua, world class research facilities, di mana university kita mendapatkan pendanaan, kemudian banyak juga yang disponsor oleh private company maupun oleh pemerintah. Okay. Yang mana mereka akan merecognize bahwa university tersebut punya students yang memang siap untuk masuk di dunia kerja. Dan banyak yang especially research university, mereka memberikan banyak privilege kepada students-nya, fasilitas, dan juga pada saat student lulus, mereka banyak di-hire oleh perusahaan-perusahaan di Amerika, baik itu locals maupun international student. Post-study option tadi sudah saya mention before, ya, sama unique culture. Jadi di US itu kita punya students yang datang dari berbagai negara di dunia. US bukanlah milik white peoples, US adalah milik citizen of US. Datang dari beragam warna kulit, ya, beragam background, religions, dan juga beragam pasti speaking other language. Ya, kalau di Indonesia, we can see that kita banyak ragam suku bangsa, kalau di US beragamnya di banyaknya warga negaranya, dari beragam warga negara. Karena penduduk Amerika, citizen Amerika boleh memiliki dua warga negara. Indonesia kan hanya single. So they are citizen of US, but they also can be citizen of Singapore, they can be citizen of UK, Inggris, they can be citizen of German and others. But Indonesia nggak boleh ya. Indonesia hanya boleh singles as citizen. And then satu yang menyatakan bahwa unique culture dan welcome, kita punya toleransi yang tinggi, itu ada di pemerintahan yang mungkin semua sudah tahu, pemilu terakhir di mana Amerika membuat satu hit yang berbeda, ya, hopefully di negara-negara juga di mana minoritas bisa di ini adalah wakil presidennya adalah perempuan pertama, ya, menjadi wakil presiden di Amerika. Dengan background, kita orang Asia harus proud karena dia backgroundnya adalah orang Afrika dan India. Dia dibesarkan oleh Indian culture. India ya, bukan Indian. India culture. Okay. Tadi saya minta guessing berapa. Jadi di US ini saya ngambil dari four negara yang menjadi adalah Western speak, English speaking country yang menjadi destinasi dari anak-anak Indonesia, yaitu US, UK, Canada, and Australia. Oke, okay, kalau US tadi saya mention ada berapa? Hampir 4.000 ya, four years universities, sedangkan di UK hanya 154, dan di Kanada ada 98, dan Australia ada 43. Jadi US adalah negara yang mempunyai terbanyak university di dunia. Mungkin kalau berminat untuk ke US, tadi ada yang nanya, oh gimana ya di US-nya itu, diklasifikasi kotanya seperti apa? Oke. Okay. College town itu apabila penduduknya itu hanya sekitar paling banyak 150, K itu adalah ribu ya, biar gampang udah ditulis nolnya banyak, 10 sampai 150 ribu itu college town. Berapa sih biaya hidup tinggal di kota tersebut? Paling banyak 1.000, itu udah makan, tempat tinggal, dan lain-lain. Kemudian medium city yaitu 150 sampai 300, contohnya college town seperti apa? Salah satu uni yang saya ini adalah Auburn University, ada beberapa anak LPDP ya yang juga sudah graduate from this university ya, ada yang dari banyak dari Indonesia bagian timur yaitu dari NTT, juga dari Papua karena waktu itu BIT hanya cover 5 provinsi dan mereka sudah lulus ya dari Auburn University because only 2 years. Medium city 150K sampai 300 itu seperti area di Kansas ya, di Kansas itu kota di negara bagian atau dibilang center of US. Itu tengahnya Amerika. Ya, kurang lebih 1000 sampai 1500. Large city dengan penduduknya hampir mendekati 1 juta itu sekitar 1500 sampai 2000. Metropolitan seperti apa? Mungkin sudah pernah tahu New York, LA, Chicago itu adalah metropolitan city. Dengan jumlah penduduk lebih dari 1 juta, biaya hidup pun akan lebih besar. Oke. Okay? And then next, sedikit yang saya ini adalah mengenai di US itu dengan 4.000, kita merankingkan seperti apa? Oke, okay, kita punya namanya tier. First tier itu adalah top 200, second tier adalah top 2000, dan third tier adalah top 4000. Kita tidak ngomong sampai 2000-an ya, kita hanya ngomong sampai 500 saja. Ini perbandingan biaya. Imagine if you have to pay like this, of course a lot. Belum lagi biaya hidup ya, yang tadi tinggal kalau sudah screenshot bisa lihat, oke okay, kalau saya di kota kecil berapa kali 1 bulan 1000, kalau kali 12 bulan berarti 12.000. Kalau kali saya kuliah S2-nya 2 tahun berarti 24.000, ya kan? Kalau saya kuliah di private pasti banyak. Makanya webinar kali ini mengenai tips and trick untuk scholarship, it will help you a lot, ya. Jadi imagine yang harusnya bayar sampai umpama kalau saya mau masuk top 50. Top 50 itu uni seperti apa ya? Of course Harvard, Yale, Stanford, semua Ivy League school atau private university ada di top 50. Jadi di top 50 itu ada sekitar 35 private university dan 15 public university. Ya. Dengan biaya kuliah per tahun, ini per tahunnya kurang lebih seperti ini. Double public ya, harusnya itu adalah private. Sorry for the typo. private UG. UG itu adalah S1, PG ya, private PG itu adalah S2 yang saya mention di sini hanya untuk PG itu adalah hanya untuk S2. Karena PhD itu biaya berbeda, malah ada yang free. Okay. Jadi bisa dilihat bahwa range untuk private, kuliah di private university itu memang lebih mahal ya. Itu applied ke everywhere, mau di US, di Indonesia, atau di negara lain pun, selalu private university lebih mahal daripada public university. Dikarenakan public university mendapatkan pendanaan full dari pemerintah, seperti universitas-universitas cendana pastinya tidak mahal karena sekolah negeri, tapi kalau sekolah swasta pasti lebih mahal dari itu. Nah, imagine dengan biaya hidup, kemudian ini, kalau kita harus bayar, wow, fantastis angkanya. Tapi kalau kita dapat scholarship, ya, you don't have to pay, malah biasanya biaya hidup itu ada sponsor tertentu, ya. Kalau kamu dapat scholarship, you dapat namanya monthly pocket money. Ada yang range ya, ada yang dari 1.000 sampai ada hampir 2.000 per bulan. Jadi tinggal gimana kamu arrange, karena biaya kuliah semuanya dibayar oleh kalau kamu dapat scholarship atau sponsor yang akan bayar, dan sponsor akan transfer bulanan ke rekening student masing-masing. Ya, tinggal kalian, saya balik slide lagi ya. Oh, kalau saya tinggal di kota besar itu, kalau saya dapat 1.000, berarti saya harus hemat-hemat ya. Ini kan kurang lebih ya. Tapi kalau saya di medium city, saya dapat uang saku 1.500. Kalau gitu, saya sudah perkirakan nih, gimana nih medium city-nya apa aja. Nanti kalau for the discussion, if you need more details, I'm happy ya untuk talk lebih details. Karena ini webinar, kita hanya punya waktu yang tidak banyak. Akan saya mention kota-kota mana saja, sehingga kalau umpama, you get a scholarship, saya dapat 1.500, berarti memungkinkan atau tidak, gimana tips-tipsnya nih supaya saya punya bulanannya lebih rendah, sehingga saya bisa saving dikit, ya. Hitung-hitung bulanannya bisa di-save, jadi selesai kuliah pulang bisa bawa uangnya, ya. Okay. Okay, so list uni yang saya memang tidak banyak ya, tadi sudah dimention 20. Kita baru mempunyai satu uni yang kita bantu. This is a fantastic because this is watch out, this is a university on the top. Ini adalah university yang ada di list LPDP, baik itu untuk semua kategori, baik itu top rank dunia ya, world ranking. John Hopkins masuk di dalam listnya, kemudian masuk juga di saya lupa deh nama scholarship ya, untuk semua LPDP, John Hopkins University masuk di list university yang ada di LPDP yang dikeluarkan tahun 2021. Uni yang lain ada beberapa, tapi saya rasa tidak banyak yang sudah tidak masuk lagi di 2021, karena setiap tahun LPDP merubah list of university. Okay. Tapi apa yang apabila ada di sini sudah mendapatkan beasiswa 2020 kemarin, beberapa uni yang ada di list ini adalah uni yang terlistit juga di list LPDP sebelum 2021. Okay. Yep. So this is a list, watch out, it's a private, John Hopkins is a private, ranking number 9 di US, ranking 19 dinominasi oleh private university. Okay. Ranking 20 baru University of California, Los Angeles. Itu adalah public university. This is peta Amerika, beberapa yang tidak belum ada di sini, belum update ya, dia ada di mana ya. Kalau John Hopkins itu dia ada di bersama dengan American University, ada di DC, di District of Columbia, di ibu kota negara Amerika. Ya, seperti itu. Okay, sorry I'm not putting the scholarship list for graduate atau S2, tapi ini adalah untuk Molly untuk S1. So, di S1, bachelor degree-nya itu adalah 4 tahun. So, ada yang nanya, gimana sih sistem di US? Itu mirip dengan Indonesia. Pada saat Indonesia memform the system, pakar-pakar kita berangkat ke Amerika untuk belajar. sehingga ada sedikit kesamaan antara US system dan Indonesian system. Oke. Dari length of study di Indonesia, bachelor atau strata 1 kan 4 tahun, di US pun 4 tahun, S2 2 tahun, S3 itu 3 sampai 5 tahun, which is agak mirip ya. Kemudian kalau bachelor degree di Indonesia itu ada 3 komponen. Correct me if I'm wrong, itu adalah mata kuliah umum, mata kuliah wajib, dan mata kuliah pilihan. Di US pun sama, we have general education sama dengan MKDU in Indonesia. We have mata kuliah wajib atau di sana adalah core subject. And mata kuliah pilihan di US adalah elective subject. Berbeda dengan Commonwealth, Commonwealth hanya punya 2. Okay? Commonwealth itu diwakilkan oleh UK, Australia, New Zealand, Kanada tidak, karena Kanada mengikuti sistemnya US, walaupun dia sebenarnya part dari Commonwealth. So, jadi yang di Commonwealth, mereka hanya punya 2, yaitu mata kuliah wajib dan mata kuliah pilihan. Ya, tidak ada mata kuliah umum. Oke. Okay? Nah, beasiswa di over ada yang 4 years, ada yang 1 year, but it's not full because this is given by the university. Ini adalah partial tuition fee scholarship. That's for bachelor. How much for master? Sorry, I'm not putting in here, but master that from the university listing yang saya punya, mereka offer hanya maximum 5% from the tuition fee. Jadi range ya, ada yang berikan 1.000, ada yang berikan sampai 5.000, itu untuk 1 tahun. Master degree hanya 2 tahun sekolah. Oke. Okay. So, and then, kalau saya dapat beasiswa, saya bisa nggak beasiswa lagi? Tergantung beasiswa yang kamu dapat. Contoh ada anak LPDP yang tanya saya, Mi, saya sudah dapat full scholarship from LPDP. Bisa nggak saya apply lagi scholarship at the university? Saya bilang bahwa university happy ya kalau kamu apply dan if you meet the requirement and you compete and you menang, kamu bisa dapat. Tapi again, biasanya LPDP against with that. Tapi kalau kamu tahu bahwa US government also memberikan beasiswa dari pemerintah Amerika lewat embassy US, kalau kamu dapat beasiswa itu, maka kamu boleh juga apply beasiswa dari university. Oke. Okay? Jadi kamu bisa dapat kamu bisa apply for others scholarship. Yang saya tahu LPDP tidak boleh apply other scholarship. Tapi kalau untuk US ya, yeah, you apply you dapat beasiswa dari pemerintah Amerika, kamu boleh juga mungkin apply ke one of the university listed with me atau others university in US. You eligible also to apply, and if you meet the requirement, everything, you can get the scholarship and you eligible for that. Jadi, itu sedikit informasi yang saya berikan. Kemudian, how to get a scholarship, for example, yang I do for the bachelor and master. Setiap scholarship itu pasti punya requirement yang berbeda-beda. Okay? Untuk partial tuition scholarship, the first, you have to meet the entry requirement of the academy. For the bachelor degree, the minimum GPA have to be 3.0 out of 4. Okay, easy for Indonesia karena sistemnya sama. Other country kan GPA bukan 0 sampai 4 ya. Mereka ada namanya distinction credit, itu for Australia, mirip dengan UK. Tapi Indonesia, if you apply, kamu ada di high school, contohnya tertarik untuk bachelor degree, you can apply for that, sorry. For master degree, means you have to earn, if you from Nusa Cendana, University of Others, the minimum GPA have to be 3.0. That's one of the requirement. The second, there's a university request for you to write an essay. Yeah, might be there will be a tips from through the webinar about the how to make the good essay. So watch out and wait until this seminar end because you will get the tips for that. And then also the other one, we require for the interview for the scholarship. The interview will, for the scholarship will be through the Zoom. Of course, you cannot meet the representative directly face to face. There will be like, if the representative is in Indonesia, usually the person will do the interview for scholarship, or will it will be Indonesian office hour. But if it's from a campus interviewer, that means you have to prepare yourself, because we are different in 12, 11 until 14 hours with Indonesia. Indonesia ahead from US. So for example, now if different in 12 hours, we are now is what time? Let me see my clock. Ah, I'm done with that. It's now 2:40. It means in Boston, it's 2:40 a.m. Okay, that's all from me. I think this is the last slide from me. So that's, thank you so much. I'll give it back to the moderator.
Thank you very much, Ibu Rini. Interesting. This is the information that we hardly get from internet, because it's really, really specific. And to the audience, if you need Ibu Rini's contact, you can just take a picture of that contact and maybe send some emails. But if you have question right now, you can type in chat box, and we can see that there are several questions already. But for a wrap up the presentation, may I tell the audience that the USA have several reason why we choose the USA for our university destination. For the first one is academic excellence, and world-class research facilities, scholarship, connection in leading industry, post-study work option, and unique cultural experiences. And also, just like Indonesia, living cost is very in the USA. So don't worry if you have a little bit low in living cost from your scholarship, you can make it out. And we also can get partial scholarship or for bachelor or master degree, depends on our achievement of academic achievement. So for the question and answer session, I will call my colleagues here, Christiani. Over to you, Christiani. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Miss Grace. So good afternoon, everyone. We just listened to Ibu Rini's presentation. Thank you so much, Ibu Rini, for the amazing presentation. My name is Christiani Babanong, and I have this chance to lead this Q&A session. So Ibu Rini, I will read the questions and you can answer the question right after that. So the first question coming from Ibu Leni Swek. The question is, Ibu Rini, is it possible for your institution to assist us in getting LOA from Harvard University? Any tips for getting unconditional LOA and supervisors for PhD from that university? Thank you.
Okay, thank you for the question. This is about the Harvard University. For the Harvard University, they are not have someone, a rep representative them in Indonesia. So unfortunately, you have to contact directly to Harvard. But if you're talking about Johns Hopkins, might be we try, because we just start partner with them for assist international students to the university. For the PhD, almost all the university, they will request the students to contact them directly. Yeah, for the PhD. Okay, the student for students candidate for the PhD, they have to contact the faculty at the university by themselves, except if you apply for the bachelor or master degree. Hope it's answer.
Thank you, Rini. The second question coming from Mr. Mbewe. The question is, ma'am, in this current situation, there's a lot of discrimination and shooting these days. My question is US safe for international students?
The answer is yes, because discriminations, you know, everywhere, right? We talk about minority and majority. So as I mentioned before, we are uniculture. We welcome U.S. welcome everyone. With the COVID right now, you know, lots of country that close the border. Ya, banyak negara yang tutup bordernya, tapi U.S. tidak pernah tutup border. Okay. Kedua, di pemerintahan, ya, kita represent minority. Okay, Joe Biden, the president, is the minority in religion. The majority religion is Christianity. So he's a Catholic. He's the minority religion in U.S. The vice president is backgroundnya dia adalah the first woman ya dalam sejarah Amerika. Kemudian background dia adalah dari Afrika Asia, which never happened before. President before, of course, Obama. Ia juga ada history dengan Indonesia, ya. Dan Amerika itu warga negaranya itu bukan hanya satu citizen adalah white aja. And then the media also memegang peranan penting dalam every aspect yang happen di suatu negara. Dan US adalah negara yang mempunyai paham kebebasan. You can tell everything, but kebebasan itu ada aturan-aturannya. So, about the discrimination, yes, pasti ada diskriminasi. Namanya dimanapun ada majority and minority, ya kan? Tapi selama itu tidak berhubungan dengan hukum, ya, mereka tidak over the regulation yang ada, biasanya boleh, karena setiap orang boleh memiliki kebebasan. Ya, kalau di Indonesia demo itu hal yang aneh, di US boleh, karena itu kebebasan dalam bersuara. Ya, kecuali kalau sudah demonstrasi kemudian rusak, berarti itu kebebasan yang melewati hukum, akan berhadapan dengan hukum. Right. Shooting karena di US mungkin negara yang tadi according to kebebasan dengan patungnya liberty, artinya boleh menggunakan senjata, mereka boleh ada regulation, boleh legal ya itu legal punya senjata yang memang ya apa ya pemerintah juga lagi berusaha bagaimana kejahatan itu bisa di ini imagine dengan penduduknya beragam warga negara dengan karakter yang berbeda ya, jadi diskriminasi ada karena majority minority, tapi itu bukan hal yang sangat luar biasa di Amerika. Okay. Semoga menjawab.
Thank you, Ibirini. So the next question come from Mikaela Sylvia. So the question is based on what I've read. Before those who want to be a part of US citizen, they got green card or US permanent resident. So do they still get the facilities in education that same with the citizen?
Okay, pertanyaannya bagus. Okay, benar. Green card di Amerika sama dengan PR in Commonwealth. Okay, Commonwealth system menggunakan kurinya permanent residence. Kalau dia US adalah green card. Citizen di semua negara sama. Yes, green card dulu baru citizen. Jadi banyak yang dapatnya bisa lewat jalur lottery. Ya, you can try. Ya, banyak seluruh dunia, seluruh orang apply lottery tiap tahun ada tuh, ada kuotanya. Yes, you can apply. And then dari pendidikan, yes. Jika kamu sekolah di sana, kamu bekerja yang tadi saya bilang setelah kuliah, kamu bekerja di US ya, up to bisa 3 tahun ya. Kemudian kamu lanjutkan lagi bekerja, kamu punya hak untuk apply for green card. Ya. Pasti lewat banyak proses yang ada. Okay. Atau marriage, by marriage. If you marry the citizen of US ya, either yang wife atau husband di sana, you bisa menjadi citizen of US. Nanti ada prosesnya, prosedurnya. Saya nggak bisa mention karena itu bagian dari immigration rules. Okay. Apakah mereka dapat fasilitas yang sama? Yes, once you already been green card, beda green card dan citizen hanya di voting. If you are green card, you nggak bisa vote pemilu, tapi you citizen, you bisa pemilu. Itu aja, tapi fasilitas semua sama dengan antara green card dan citizen.
Okay. Thank you, Ibu Rini. The next question come from Kasturia Adam. Ma'am, in all scholarship pathways, what are the most common problems that make students fail to get scholarship? Thank you.
Scholarship pathway, what are most common problems? I don't get it. Okay, if you apply for the scholarship, ya, ada university yang, saya nggak tahu ini versinya apa, kalau versi yang dari university, if you dapat beasiswa dari university, ada yang 1 tahun, ada yang 4 tahun for bachelor, ada yang 1 tahun, ada yang 2 tahun for master, ya, tergantung length of study. Bayarnya kan per semester. If you pay by semester the tuition fee and you GPA below the minimum, ya, untuk eligible for reduction of the tuition fee, ada uni yang langsung otomatis cut, ada university yang masih mau memberikan kesempatan ke students, dan student harus appealing dan memberikan penjelasan kenapa GPA-nya di bawah 3.0. Ya. Most problem, what are the most problems that make students fail to get scholarship? You mean apply for the scholarship? Yeah, because you have to meet the, kalau dari university, ya, yeah, yang kita berikan scholarship, if you don't meet the requirement GPA equivalent 3.0, you are not eligible waktu you apply. And then banyak juga ada faktor di fail di interview, okay? Or you fail in writing, ya, yeah? Jadi itu tipsnya. GPA harus bagus, ada essay yang harus kamu buat harus bagus, essay jangan fake, essay about yourself, and then interview juga about yourself. Jadi be prepared for that.
Thank you so much, Ibu Rini, for answering all the questions. That will be the last question due to the time limit. And thank you so much for sharing your knowledge with us this afternoon. Now I'm going to give it back to the moderator. Miss Grace, time is yours.
Thank you, Christiani. Interesting. Looks like most of us really curious about this topic. But if you won't mind, could you please reply on chat box, Ibu Rini, for the rest of the question that haven't answered live. Thank you very much before. And thank you for attending this webinar again and sharing your knowledge with us. I hope to see you another time. Thank you very much. And now I will offer to Ibu Selvi for continuing this webinar. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, Miss Grace. And also thank you, Ibu Rini, for the presentation. And also thank you to Christiani for leading us in the question and answer session.